Thanks, Michael O'Brien. And now we are in a very important issue about the launch of the European Alliance of Cities and Regions for Roma Inclusion. It is a great pleasure for me to see the fruition of more than a year of efforts in the development of the European Alliance of Cities and Regions for Roma Inclusion, and I am happy today to launch the Alliance, the cooperation framework of cities and regions aimed at ensuring inclusion of the Roma population across Europe at local and regional level. In Europe, where we speak about universal human rights, equality and inclusion, the situation of 12 million of the Roma community remains our common concern. It is within our, as local and regional authorities, scope of activities and responsibilities to ensure that the Roma, as fully fledged European citizens, enjoy the same rights and fully participate in the life of their town and regions. This is our firm conviction from which the idea of the Alliance has been born. The idea of creating the Alliance came out of the Summit of Mayors on Roma, co-organized by the Congress of Local and Regional Authorities and the special representatives of the Secretary General for Roman Issues and his support team in September 2011. It is not surprising that the initiative of the Alliance was first presented and later developed by local and regional authorities. It is at the grassroots where the problems occur and where the most practical solutions are found. It is at this level where direct interaction between Roma and non-Roma communities take place, and it is in our towns and regions where national strategies and measures are being implemented. It is local and regional authorities that can make a real change for the better, a change in people's attitudes and perceptions, a change in priorities for action to improve the situation of Roma. The Alliance project, built on numerous examples of local and regional initiatives and even networks, will serve to bring these efforts together. It is also an excellent example of close cooperation between municipalities and regions and the Council of Europe. We welcome this cooperation and will make sure that it remains in the core of activities of the Alliance. We are happy to announce that on this day of our official launch, we have some 100 cities and regions of all sizes and from all parts of Europe which have confirmed their interest to participate in the activities of the Alliance. I welcome the representatives of some of these cities and regions here. We are sure that this is just the beginning and the Alliance will grow and expand. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like now to say a couple of words about the plans of the Alliance for the near future. Firstly, that all cities and regions participating in the Alliance will be able to participate in an extensive circle of activities. The Alliance will inform the cities of the events planned, provide networking opportunities and a stable flow of communication and information. Secondly, the cities and regions which are ready for further involvement will be able to join an intensive cycle of activities during which the cities will be able to take part in local consultations, workshops and study visits. In conclusion, I would like to reiterate that the Congress is firmly committed to pursuing and strengthening the dialogue between municipalities and regions across Europe, aimed at enhancing their capacity and cooperation to achieve the common goal, which is in the inclusion of the Roma community into public life at local and regional level. I am confident that this launch is just the beginning of a fruitful work of the LA Alliance, and I wish all of us every success in this endeavor. Thank you very much. I would like to give the floor now to the Deputy Secretary General, Mrs. Gabriella Batteini Dragoni, to open the launch ceremony for the European Alliance of Cities and Regions for Roma Inclusion. Please.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Dear members of the Congress, Excellencies, in particular the Chairman, the President of the our friend Rudo Kaczynski, who is the President of the European Roma and Travelers Forum. Dear friends, I have a very positive and strong memory of the previous meeting we had together when you met here a few months ago at your previous session, and where I had the honor to address you in plenary and also to answer to the questions that the distinguished members of the Congress were addressing to me. I'm back today, again with a lot of pleasure and a lot of determination, and I'm really honored to address you today and to launch, together with you, Mr. President, Mr. Van Staar, the European Alliance of Cities and Regions for Roma Inclusion. Yesterday, I was not here with you, but I know that in his address to you, the Secretary General, Mr. Jagland, outlined the vision on how to counter several preoccupying trends in Europe, such as the rise in extremism and hate speech, new nationalism, vilification of immigration, and any other form of what we call otherness. You will not have failed to notice the importance which was put on the need to address the situation of Roma in Europe. Their situation is a shame for this continent and a shame for all of us. Roma are fellow Europeans. There are no inherent reasons why a Roma child should not achieve as well as any other child. Yet the blunt statistics show that they are far more likely to be excluded from school and underperform in their education. There are no inherent reasons why a Roma should not be as healthy as any other, yet their life expectancy is 10 years below the general average for men and 12 years less for women. Over the past several years, the Council of Europe has put a lot of energy and resources into improving the situation of Roma in Europe and promoting Roma inclusion and full respect of their human rights. Concrete action is and will remain at the heart of the Council of Europe work. In October 2010, the Member States of the Council of Europe adopted the Strasbourg Declaration on Roma. The declaration acknowledged the crucial role of local and regional authorities in ensuring the inclusion of Roma. It was not accidental that the Council of Europe started to work at the local level through its program of training Roma mediators to work in local communities, the very well-known ROMED program. Through this joint program of the Council of Europe and the European Commission, over 1,000 Roma mediators in more than 20 countries have already been trained. Hundreds of local and regional authorities have been associated in the training sessions. As we advanced with the program, we saw important gaps and a huge need to strengthen the capacities of municipalities and regions to develop effective policies for Roma inclusion. It was against this background that the Summit of Mayors was convened in September 2011, which ultimately led to the decision to create the European Alliance of Cities and Regions for Roma Inclusion. I am happy today to see that 16 months later, the time has now come to launch the Alliance. The Alliance is a great example of transversality of the work of the Council of Europe. The initiative received support from the Committee of Ministers and will continue to be carried out in close cooperation with the Special Representative of the Secretary General for Roma Issues and with other bodies within the Council of Europe. This transversality should, however, not be limited to the boundaries of this organization. It should involve other partners and organizations, and I'm therefore very pleased to hear about the interest and the support to the Alliance expressed by the European Commission. It is important for the European and international organizations to work together in order to mobilize a strong action at local and regional level. The overwhelming majority of the Member States of the Council of Europe have adopted well-thought through and broad national strategies for Roma inclusion. It is high time to ensure that these strategies also translate into local action. Many municipalities are committed to that. What they need is support, expertise, and resources. We must help them get it, offer all the backing they need, and mobilize others to follow suit. This is why I welcome the idea of setting up an international coalition for Roma inclusion, a coalition which will have the Alliance as its operational pillar and which will bring together the Council of Europe, the European Commission, the United Nations Development Programme, the World Bank, as well as Council of Europe Development Bank. Only by pooling our resources and ideas together, we have a chance to succeed. Ladies and gentlemen, in the 21st century and on the continent that invented the concept of human rights, Roma continue to live in appalling conditions which violate, I repeat, which violate many Council of Europe standards. They continue to attend segregated schools and classes very often, have no access to services, and are indeed victims of hate speech. Anti-Gypsyism and racial violence towards Roma is unfortunately on the rise. We, all of us together, have the duty not to fail this initiative. I count very much on your support to make sure that the Alliance of Cities and Regions finds its right place in the work on Roma inclusion. Indeed, I want the Alliance of Cities to fight against poverty and not against poor people. Therefore, I wish the Alliance all the best in this work, and you can count on my support and determination to make sure that it is a success. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Mrs. Deputy Secretary General, for this inspiring opening remarks. We will now see a video message from the European Commissioner for Regional Policy, Johannes Hahn. Please start.
Dear Mr. President, dear members of the Congress of the Council of Europe, the role of the local and regional authorities as the administrative unit which is closer to the citizen is very important. It's commonly accepted that local and regional authorities are better placed to identify problems affecting everyday lives and to come up with solutions. In this context, your involvement in promoting socio-economic inclusion is crucial, and I am very pleased to address your plenary debate on fighting social exclusion at local and regional level. I would like to take this opportunity to congratulate you on today's launch ceremony of the European Alliance of Cities and Regions for Roma Inclusion. I am sure that the Alliance will serve as a platform of cooperation and exchange of experience between the local and the regional authorities. Cities and regions will be able, through the Alliance, to further develop their capacity in delivering socio-economic inclusion of marginalized Roma. I'm also very pleased to note that the objectives of the Alliance are aligned with the EU framework for the national Roma integration strategies. As you know, the European Union framework invites member states to adopt national strategies aimed at improving the economic and social situation of Roma by 2020. This initiative aims at implementing the Europe 2020 objectives of smart, sustainable and inclusive growth. However, this issue transcends boundaries and requires coordinated action by all relevant partners. This is why the European Commission has been working closely with the United Nations Development Programme and the World Bank in developing data collection and monitoring methods. These tools have enabled us to start designing evidence-based policies on Roma inclusion and will allow us to better target investments from the structural funds. It's now widely established that an integrated approach is needed to tackle Roma social inclusion, an approach which combines housing, education, health and employment. It's now also evidently clear that without resolving the housing problem, actions in the other fields will not be effective. A European Union integrating housing pilot project in 9 member states, supported by structural funds, has produced some very encouraging first results. And it also helped us understand a very important lesson, namely that the local and regional authorities need a great deal of expertise and technical assistance in delivering integrated socio-economic policies for Roma. With this in mind, the European Commission explored in January the creation of a coalition of international organizations in order to provide expertise and technical assistance to local authorities. The coalition will consist of international organizations active in Roma inclusion issues, bringing together the European Union, the Congress of Local and Regional Authorities of the Council of Europe, the World Bank, the United Nations Development Programme and the Council of Europe Development Bank. I believe that you have a special role in the coalition, representing the local and regional authorities who engage in delivering socio-economic inclusion strategies. I look forward to working with you to address together this very important common concern. I am sure that together we can make our Europe more inclusive.
Thanks to Commissioner Hahn for his message. I will now give the floor to the President of the European Roma Travelers Forum, Mr. Kavczynski. Mr. Kavczynski, please.
Thank you, dear President of the Congress, dear Deputy Secretary General, dear mayors, dear ladies and gentlemen, it's a great privilege for me to take part in the launching of the European Alliance of Cities and Regions for Roma Inclusion at this 24th session of the Congress of Local and Regional Authorities. As we all too aware, Roma today are the most marginalized ethnic group in Europe. They face persistent discrimination and prejudice when it comes to access to housing, education, healthcare, and employment. These are all the areas where local and regional authorities have key responsibilities. The majority of European Roma live in the poorest areas. We estimate that there are some more than 30,000 Roma slums in Europe, and the figure is rising. This highlights the need to mobilize and coordinate local and regional action to improve the conditions in which Roma live. As underlined by the 27 member states of the Council of Europe in the Strasbourg Declaration of October 2010, local and regional action is crucial, notably for the implementation of national strategies for Roma inclusion. They need to be supported and facilitated by international organizations, and I am glad that the Council of Europe has taken up this role through the Alliance. The European Roma and Travelers Forum is convinced that the local and regional authorities have a crucial role to play in improving the situation of Roma. It is in our towns and regions that relationships issues between Roma and non-Roma population and public authorities arise, often against the background of mistrust, tension, and outreached hostility. At the same time, this offers an opportunity to work together side by side to find solutions. It is comforting that the number of municipalities and regions involved in this initiative is growing. This gives me a hope that we are on the right track and that the tragic events of the past will not become common practice in the municipalities where Roma live. The European Roma Travelers Forum offers its support, knowledge, and expertise in putting your program into practice. Moreover, the ERTF is ready to assist in the process of establishing a dialogue between Roma communities and the local authorities. Ladies and gentlemen, the Alliance project is timely needed because the situation of Roma remains an affront to our democratic ideas and values. It is also timely because the new programming period of the European Social Fund, which will begin in 2014, will have a particular emphasis on the involvement of local and regional authorities in Roma inclusion. But all these efforts will come to nothing unless both national and local authorities are politically committed to make radical reforms. Cosmetic modification intending to please the Roma without unpleasing the general public will not bring the chances or the chance we want to see. This political commitment needs to be accompanied by a genuine goodwill on the part of politicians who should be the first to give a good example by refraining from rash and discriminatory remarks. We hope that this project is political and will be committed, and goodwill will be forthcoming at this project. We can offer you, as I said, all our support to make this initiative really successful. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Kavczynski, for your encouraging words. I'm sure the Alliance will work in close cooperation with the Roma communities and in particular with the Forum as a representative and these communities in the Council of Europe. Some cities have actively participated in the development of the Alliance since the idea of the initiative at the Summit of Mayors in 2011. We are fortunate to have the city of Heraklion in Greece represented here today, and I would like to now to give the floor to the Deputy Mayor, Mrs. Singelaki. Please, Mrs. Singelaki.
Σας ευχαριστώ. Αξιότιμη Πρόεδρε, αξιότιμη αναπληρωτή Γενική Γραμματεία του Συμβουλίου της Ευρώπης, μέλη του Κογκρέσου, αγαπητοί συνάδελφοι της Αυτοδιοίκησης, κυρίες και κύριοι. Είμαι χαρούμενη που βρίσκομαι εδώ για να μοιραστώ με όλους εσάς τη στιγμή της έναρξης της Ευρωπαϊκής Συμμαχίας των Πόλεων και των Περιφερειών για την ένταξη των Ρωμά κατά τη διάρκεια μιας συζήτησης για τον κοινωνικό αποκλεισμό. Η πόλη του Ηρακλείου, την οποία εκπροσωπώ εδώ, ακολούθησε την πρωτοβουλία αυτή από την αρχή, από τη Σύνοδο Κορυφής των Δημάρχων το Σεπτέμβριο του 2011 έως σήμερα, συμβάλλοντας στην ανάπτυξη της έννοιας και της διαδικασίας της διαβούλευσης για την εκδήλωση αυτή. Σήμερα μπορούμε να δούμε αυτή την ιδέα να έχει πλήρως μεγαλώσει και αναπτυχθεί. Η Συμμαχία είναι ένα μοναδικό πρόγραμμα, καθώς ξεκίνησε και αναπτύχθηκε από τις πόλεις και τις περιφέρειες. Μετά τη Σύνοδο Κορυφής των Δημάρχων, μία ομάδα πυρήνας των πόλεων κτίστηκε. Η βασική ομάδα ανέπτυξε ένα ερωτηματολόγιο, το οποίο εστάλει στους εκπροσώπους των πόλεων και των περιφερειών, για να είναι περισσότερο ευαισθητοποιημένοι για τις ανάγκες και τις προσδοκίες τους. Με βάση τα αποτελέσματα του ερωτηματολογίου, η έννοια και το πρόγραμμα της Συμμαχίας σχηματίστηκε ανάλογα. Υπάρχουν όμως πολλά ερωτηματικά ακόμη για τη συνέχεια της προσπάθειας αυτής. Κυρίες και κύριοι, σε μια περίοδο που η κρίση πλήττει σφοδρά όχι μόνο τη χώρα μου, αλλά ολόκληρη την Ευρώπη, λαμβάνοντας χαρακτήρα βαθιάς κοινωνικής κρίσης, καλούμαστε να αναλογιστούμε τις συνέπειες, κυρίως στα πιο ευάλωτα κοινωνικά στρώματα, την ανασφάλεια και το φόβο που διακατέχει τους πολίτες. Η εκρηκτική άνοδος εγκληματικότητας, δυστυχώς, δεν θα είναι η μόνη παράπλευρη απώλεια της κρίσης σε κοινωνικό επίπεδο. Παγκοσμίως, η εμπειρία έχει δείξει ότι σε περιόδους ύφεσης οι πιο αδύναμοι υποφέρουν περισσότερο, ενώ παράλληλα αυξάνεται ραγδαία ο ρατσισμός, η περιθωριοποίηση του διαφορετικού, οι επιθέσεις, ο φασισμός. Από τα πρώτα θύματα είναι οι μετανάστες, οι Ρωμά, αλλά και όλοι οι αδύναμοι, όπως οι γυναίκες, τα παιδιά, τα άτομα με αναπηρία. Οι Δήμοι στην Ελλάδα, αλλά φαντάζομαι και σε όλη την Ευρώπη, υποφέρουν από την κρίση και την έλλειψη χρηματοδότησης, ειδικά όταν οι επιπτώσεις ύφεσης αυξάνονται. Καθημερινά, όλο και περισσότεροι πολίτες στρέφονται στο Δήμο ζητώντας τρόφιμα, φάρμακα, εργασία. Μέσα σε αυτό το ασφιχτικό οικονομικό περιβάλλον, οι ανάγκες κάνουν τον άνθρωπο πιο ευαίσθητο, πιο απαιτητικό, αλλά ταυτόχρονα και πιο σκληρό. Η κίνηση αυτή του Συμβουλίου της Ευρώπης και όλων των τοπικών αρχών που συμμετέχουμε φέρνει σε μια ιδιαίτερη συγκυρία στο προσκήνιο το ζήτημα των Ρωμά παράλληλα με το ζήτημα των μεταναστών και των προσφύγων, των αναγκών, των ανησυχιών, των δικαιωμάτων και των υποχρεώσεών τους. Παράλληλα όμως φωτίζει την αλληλεγγύη και την ανθρωπιά των συμπολιτών μας, όσων τουλάχιστον επιμένουν να μην ξεχωρίζουν άνθρωπο από άνθρωπο, να σέβονται έμπρακτα την ανθρώπινη αξία χωρίς διάκριση. Στο Δήμο Ηρακλείου προσπαθούμε παρά τα οικονομικά προβλήματα να μην διακρίνουμε τους ανθρώπους που έχουν ανάγκη λόγω των ιδιαίτερων χαρακτηριστικών τους. Φροντίζουμε ώστε να έχουν όλα τα παιδιά εμβόλια, όλα τα παιδιά συσίτιο για όσους δεν μπορούν να εξασφαλίσουν φαγητό, φροντίδα για τους ηλικιωμένους ή τους αστέγους, είτε είναι Ρωμά, είτε όχι, είτε είναι Έλληνες, είτε νόμιμα διαμένονται στην Ελλάδα. Ωστόσο, χρειαζόμαστε η Συμμαχία να παίξει ένα ρόλο καθοδηγητή, ώστε να καλύψουμε το έλλειμμα γνώσης στα ευρωπαϊκά προγράμματα χρηματοδότησης. Ένα ρόλο εμπειρογνώμονα και τεχνικού συμβούλου που θα μας βοηθήσει να αξιοποιήσουμε όλα τα μέσα και τους πόρους προς όφελος των Ρωμά, αλλά και όλου του κοινωνικού συνόλου. Σε μια προοπτική εξόδου από την ύφεση, σε μια προοπτική ανάπτυξης. Όμως, οι ανάγκες είναι μεγάλες και η έμπρακτη βοήθεια όλων των ευρωπαϊκών θεσμών είναι αναγκαία, επομένως το ίδιο είναι και ο ρόλος της Συμμαχίας αναγκαίος και σημαντικός. Στη δύσκολη για τη χώρα μου και για τον Ευρωπαϊκό Νότο, αλλά και για ολόκληρη την Ευρώπη οικονομική συγκυρία, που διαμορφώνει επιπλέον συνθήκες κοινωνικής και πολιτιστικής κρίσης, θα πρέπει να δώσουμε τη μάχη όλοι μας, όχι μόνο ως πρόσωπα, αλλά και ως θεσμοί, για να προστατεύσουμε τους πιο αδύναμους. Ο Δήμος Ηρακλείου θα είναι πρωταγωνιστής σε αυτή την προσπάθεια και αρρωγώ σε κάθε κίνηση βελτίωσης της κοινωνικής συνοχής και της ασφάλειας. Τον κορυφαίο όμως ρόλο έχουν αυτοί που λαμβάνουν τις αποφάσεις σε κεντρικό επίπεδο, αυτοί που διαμορφώνουν τις εξελίξεις. Όπως ανέφερα και πριν, η πόλη του Ηρακλείου ήταν ενεργά συμμέτοχος από την αρχή αυτής της διαδικασίας και είμαι ευτυχής να βλέπω το αποτέλεσμα αυτή σήμερα. Είναι όμως μόνο η αρχή ενός ταξιδιού και από τώρα και στο εξής θα απαιτηθεί ακόμη πιο ενεργή συμμετοχή εκ μέρους των πόλων και των περιφερειών. Θα ήθελα να ενθαρρύνω τους συναδέλφους μου, τους δημάρχους και τους εκπροσώπους των τοπικών και περιφερειακών αρχών που συγκεντρωθήκαμε σήμερα εδώ για να κάνουν χρήση αυτής της πρωτοβουλίας, να γίνουν μέλος της συμμαχίας και να εργαστούν από κοινού προκειμένου να διασφαλιστεί η ύπαρξη, η διεκδίκηση αλλά και η αποτελεσματική εφαρμογή των πολιτικών με στόχο την ένταξη των Ρωμά και όλων όσοι υποφέρουν και τη βελτίωση του επίπεδου ζωής όλων μας. Εύχομαι καλή τύχη σε όλους μας. Ευχαριστώ.
Vielen Dank, Frau Vizebürgermeisterin. Ich darf Ihnen herzlich für Ihre Ausführungen danken. Eine andere Stadt, die eine ganz wichtige Rolle spielt und einen aktiven Part spielt in der Allianz, ist die Stadt Madrid. Ich darf nun Herrn Ramirez, den Direktor des Institutes für Wohnbau und soziale Integration, bitten, das Wort zu ergreifen.
Buenas tardes, presidente del Congreso, subdirectora del Consejo de Europa, comisario para la política regional, presidente del Foro Europeo de la Población Roma, representantes generales del Consejo de Europa, señoras y señores. Queremos expresar nuestro agradecimiento por la invitación a la Comunidad de Madrid, a la que hoy represento, para participar en el lanzamiento de la Alianza, en el que hemos venido trabajando activamente desde su constitución. El Gobierno Regional de Madrid, a través del IRIS, mantiene su compromiso de desmantelar todos los núcleos chabolistas, realojando a las familias, en su mayoría de etnia gitana, en viviendas situadas en un entorno urbano, integrado social y físicamente, con un objetivo claro, la integración de las familias en una situación de exclusión social. Este compromiso político, que ha supuesto un esfuerzo económico importante y que nuestro Gobierno regional sigue manteniendo, pese a la actual situación de crisis económica en la que nos encontramos, ha tenido logros muy significativos, como el desmantelamiento en nuestra región, en Madrid, de más de 100 núcleos chabolistas, lo que ha supuesto que tan solo queden en la actualidad 3 núcleos por desmantelar. Esto significa que más de 8.500 personas han dejado atrás su situación de exclusión social y residencial con la adjudicación de una vivienda en altura en un entorno normalizado. Nuestro modelo de trabajo es un referente a nivel nacional e internacional. Un 95% de las familias realojadas en vivienda en altura han conseguido alcanzar los objetivos de integración en la sociedad madrileña. Prueba de ello ha sido el reconocimiento por parte de este Consejo de Europa el pasado año 2011, concediendo al IRIS el premio DOSTA, premio del que nos sentimos especialmente orgullosos, y que aprovecho aquí para mostrar nuestro agradecimiento, que galardona las buenas prácticas a favor de la integración de la población gitana. Y este año hemos sido galardonados en el Concurso Internacional de Buenas Prácticas de Naciones Unidas con la calificación GUD por el trabajo implementado desde el Servicio de Asistencia Vecinal a SIVECAM, cuyo objetivo es mejorar la convivencia vecinal en la vivienda pública de la Comunidad de Madrid. Desde el año 2011 hemos participado de manera activa y permanente en la constitución de esta Alianza Europea de Ciudades y Regiones con el fin de constituir un marco de cooperación para compartir las buenas prácticas que se llevan a cabo para la población roma en toda Europa, que nos permita a todas las ciudades y regiones participantes transferir experiencias positivas y, en definitiva, aprender de todas ellas con un objetivo común, alcanzar la inclusión de la población gitana en Europa. Quiero dejar patente nuestra voluntad de continuar trabajando en la Alianza, formando parte del núcleo principal de trabajo, con el compromiso de mantener los valores que defienden nuestras actuaciones. Igualdad de oportunidades, derechos y deberes compartidos, tolerancia y convivencia, apostando por la búsqueda de nuevas posibilidades y caminos que contribuyan a mejorar la situación de los gitanos en Europa. Muchas gracias.
Thank you, Mr. Ramirez. This concludes this launch ceremony. I thank the Deputy Secretary General of the Council of Europe and all the speakers for all the support and encouragement they expressed to the Alliance. I invite everyone to take part in the festive reception organized by the City and the of Strasbourg in cooperation with the Alliance later this evening. Thank you very much.